Hey, it's me, Marky Joe, here to entertain you. Yes, it is my show. It exists. I don't know what I'm gonna do with it.
Yeah.
Hello everyone, Marky Joe 1990 here, and welcome back to Rage Fest 4, Trolls and Tribulations. Today, we're doing Rage Fest, Arrow in the Wind by Baldrick. I know Baldrick. He's a guy I have on Skype. He was also part of the Fire Emblem team for a while. And then I kind of narrowed that down to, like, just a few members and just never added him. If you're interested in coming back, dude, just let us know. We'll be happy to re-add you. Also, I didn't map my controls properly. You guys get to sit through this. Yay! Down. Left. Right. Yay! Okay, there we go. So, I have the perfect name. When I was playing Final Fantasy II, that is what I named the... That's what I named the girl in the game. Ooh, a mare. Damn, Sargus the Marchmare. Well, thank you. Oh, it's Black Fang Sane, maybe? What do you want? Well, he didn't even say he had evil plans. Maybe he just wants to chill out. Exactly! Oh, tech skip. Oh, wow. The game even acknowledges it. That's... Well, it's not great map design, but I already like how the game is being very self-aware of like, things like the text skip. Trigger the ending scene event. this is pretty clever already. Already getting good vibes. Alright, I need to shut up, though. Focus, Mark. What would Jesus do? He would probably move Blue Hawkeye over to here to kick the shit out of... Oh. So I can't move there. Understood. Alright, who's this? Will, or green-haired Will. Raven, with green armor. Insane! Much stupider now, good. He doesn't get any lines. Do you have any lines? Oh, it's an archer! Okay, I gotta stop fucking around. So what do I do here exactly? Don't lose. Does this... No, this doesn't have the all-unit check thing. Do they have anything special? This is what I should do at the beginning of each submission, honestly. I should just kind of check the unit stats and stuff. Also, there's a lot of archers. Wow. Well, best get to work. Stand here. Also, change my settings. There we go. And we'll just add a little save state there, just for good measure. Oh, here we go. What? All right. Oh, it's me! I named myself Sargus. Diamond Eye Joe. Maybe that's me? Like, the actual Marky Joe? Bring in the oats in. Oh, and we have dragons. And wyverns. You know, there's a thing called turning the camera off so that they can all load at once, but maybe you were intentionally trying to load them all while the camera was zooming all over the place. Too bad for those orphans. Too bad for those orphans. I like Sargus's plan to say fuck everything. Pringles. Flying away in blind panic. Okay, good. Oh, hey, Lynn. Oh, boy. So, I guess this is a matter of, kind of just working around the enemy ranges, huh? Well, they'll just corner me over here, so this seems like the correct spot. What is it? Like, if this keeps changing maps while, like, what's happening in this map, then this should be called, like, Fire Emblemware mini games or whatever. Like, whatever that game's called. Miniature Fun. Okay. Oh! So the game's aware that the tutorial events are going on. That's, again, that's pretty fucking clever. Alright, hold on. I've got this. Murder this man. Oh wow, he has bad odds against me. Also, I just realized I turned off the animations. Well, hold on. Wait, you can move again? Alright, works for me. So far, so easy. Also, these... Wait, did I rob... I don't think I'm robbing people. Though, maybe she has a steel mechanic. Oh, pitchfork. That's not happy. Yeah, that's right. I want to change my settings. Also, I can't, end my turn naturally. Alright, so let's kill this guy. Bam! Oh, I love the Pegasus, the Falcon Knight animation. Like, when she hits you, it really looks like it fucking hurts. Which is what I say about most animations in the original game, honestly. Alright, so let's go rain. Good to know. Sorry, Lynn, you're gonna lose the tutorial. What the fuck? Also, I love how some of these dragons are bosses and some aren't. I think that's on purpose, though. Yeah, because, like, the one dragon who isn't is Bramimond. Or the Dragon King. I'm not quite sure what I'm supposed to do. I think that's abundantly clear at this point. Alright, so, let's use a vulnerary here and see if that triggers an area event. Nope, didn't. So yeah, one of the things you can do is that if you use an item while using a unit that can move again, and you trigger an area event while you're using that item, you can move again and move out of the range of that, so you can kind of just trick the game into fucking up. Alright, what are my parameters against these men? Some of them cannot fight back. How strange. Well, so long as I stay away from them, I should be alright. I have no idea what the fuck to... Oh, what is that? Okay, so some you can't counterattack against. That's good to know. Bam, and some of them have really bad odds of hurting me whatsoever, so this is kind of weird. I guess I'll just wait till I kill all these dudes. Oh wow, double crit, how about that? And more defense. To make it even harder for me to get destroyed. Alright, hold on. Do I have, like, limited uses on my Iron Lance? Like, how limited are they, more accurately? I have a good amount of uses, so... Let's get rid of Pitchfork Dan right here. Up there's a rain. Good to know. And those... not an actual weapon. Well, I mean, they're annoying. I'll give them that. Oh yeah, they just don't do any damage. They just kind of waste my fucking time. Like assholes. All right, so now what? All right, so they did mention a house. Okay, I understand now. I need to dance around their ranges. Okay. I probably should have thought about that. Alright, so this is a game of luring dude. Luring dudes, rather. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so if I stand here, they'll move down. Alright, so now I kind of need to do something like this. Wow, this is such a weird fucking submission. Alright, so... run this way. Oh, but wait. I see. The pitchfork enemies are supposed to trap me. Oh, that's fucked up. That is fucking ingenious. Okay, yeah. Thank God for that move again command. Oh my god. Wow. This is fucked up. I don't know what to do. Damn it. Oh, and now I'm like double screwed because I don't have a weapon anymore. Alright, so let's start over, shall we? Alright, let's be a little bit more goal-oriented this time. So my goal is to get to this house right here. So I'm going to kind of just bolt straight for it. Or as best as I can, at the very least. Okay. Weak to water and rock taste, how's that relevant? No idea, I'm just a sentient Skrull. Oh yeah, it's more tutorial stuff. Which didn't show up last time I did this chapter, so that's a little weird. Alright, so let's take advantage of our move again feature. Murder this guy, because he's a huge obstacle. You're an obstruction in my path. Or something else that a Fire Emblem character would say. Yeah, I figured you would get in my way like that. Damn it! Okay, so I might be able to knock you out. It's all about that space management, I guess. Alright, so which are the safe spots? Alright. Somewhere around there. Oh, what? Well then, this could be bad. Or it could be good. From the looks of it, we might be in good shape because I can still outrun them. Oh, and they are coming straight for us. Also, how do I get to that place? Because I'll be in the range of them no matter what, it seems. Hold on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Damn it. Yeah, she'll be just in range. Maybe if I visit this village, or that village. Hold on, can these be visited? Yes, they can, okay. See, I'm starting to get used to how these rage fests handle things. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I'll be in that guy's range no matter what. So, bottom village it is. All right, visit. Alright, so, noted. Brahmimon does not bother to attack. So that means I can safely approach from the east. Let's see. There's not really a safe spot I can stand in. I might have to deal with these guys head on. Yeah, I'm about to get swarmed. I don't think I'm gonna be able to, like, do anything about this. At the very least, I could get some nice EXP that I can't use. Oh yeah, I am... If that guy didn't move not to the right, I would have been super double fucked. Also, I'm out of weapon. Alright, but I might be able to still do this if I don't get surrounded completely. Which is kind of gonna happen. Nope. Alright, so, at the very least, I'm gonna visit the houses here. So, save state. Oh, it's Lynn! Well then. Oh, wow. Well then. Hey, Wallace, because he's a wall. Let's see, they all have the mine. I wonder if I still have that nabbing skill. I wonder if this will work. Okay, confirmed. Marky Joe does not possess the actual steel mechanic. All right, what's in this one then? Has a chai for you? Well, that's change AI. That's an events code. Interesting. Alright, from here I might be able to make it though. Fucking do this. Fuck. Okay, hold on. I can still make it. I believe. Also, I might have miscounted the spaces. Oh, fuck. No, Brahmimon, save me! Yeah, oh, I'm fucked. And this is where I say to myself, hindsight's a bitch. Because from this position, I could have actually won the chapter. It may not seem obvious right now, but later you'll understand what I'm talking about. Alright, I think I found the blind spot. Yeah, I have no further comment, but... Okay, so there and there. So I can safely stand here, and Captain Brahm in my hand is not gonna ruin my everything. Or maybe he will? What? Alright, I think I read one of the instructions wrong. I'm gonna rewatch the video. Okay, so get this. Yeah. This is the dude that won't attack me. Good to know. Alright, so while I take care of this part, I want to briefly talk about the Lin events, the Lin tutorial events, because without ROM hacking, you probably don't know what the fuck is so funny about it. Like the whole, oh, let's strike an attack, and then suddenly, like, Farina is, like, doing all these things while Lin is talking, like how she pilfers the vulnerary that Lin got and shit. Because it's very confusing. But basically, when back in ye olden days of eventing and Fire Emblem hacking, when you modified the events of the prelude, of the prologue events, of the prologue chapter, Lin's tutorial dialogue would still happen. So, like, you'd have to find a way around it, and people did. Baldrick didn't seem to, so instead he decided to just event around it, which I think is hilarious. Oh, what? What the fuck this time? Okay, so let me get this straight. Will not attack you. He clearly did. Let's just get an instant replay just to confirm it. Yep, he definitely did attack me. Alright, so I guess we gotta do it from the top then. The one dude who... This submission is kind of really dickish. Though I can't say this is the kind that I mind too much, because this is kind of... This is hilarious. Hilariously dickish. Ugh. Oh my god, this is like the most obnoxious game of tag ever. I'm trying to get to this guy up here. That is not easy. I'm pretty sure that he's the one that doesn't kill you. But yeah, you have to really, like, there are two dragons that start up here. So it's really hard to approach from the north because they're spaced in just a way that you can't possibly get past them without, like, luring them down here or some such thing. It's really annoying. So now I have to figure out the proper way to, like, drag all these dudes, like, around the map so that I don't get stuck. I can't think of any words. Something else I forgot to mention is that you have to reach a certain point in the map before all these dragons even start moving and chasing after you. You have to be, like, somewhere around here, and then it triggers them. Oh, jeez. I think, yeah, right about here. And now they're all gonna start chasing after me. So now, I gotta get the fuck over here, or something. I have no clue, honestly. The thing is that there are so many ways they can corner me, and once it starts raining, It becomes so much worse. Alright, but I think I got this. I'll be right back. Okay, I think this is the guy that doesn't move. Let's test that theory, shall we? I'm burnt. Fucking A. He was like the only dragon that never moved and like, hold on. I'm gonna demonstrate something, alright? Actually, I don't even know what the... Oh, that really fucks with me when the AI just decides to do whatever the fuck it wants. Okay, so he does move. But before he wasn't moving, so what the fuck? Alright, seriously, this dragon is fucking with me. He's not moving. I have all these guys on my ass, but once I get close, he's gonna start moving again. Like, I don't get it. Like, I don't think I've ever seen AI act that way before. Like, usually AI either stays still or attacks you once you're in range, or it just always charges after you. But to have and the change AI codes rarely work the way they're supposed to. So this is such a weird thing to me to see an AI actually, like, start moving. Like, this must be some kind of area event thing that the game just doesn't tell me about. Wait, kill? Hold on a minute. I'm taking a risk here. Well, no, I'm not, because I'm save stating. Alright, that had something happen, because my unit paused for a very brief moment. Yeah, and this guy continues not to move, so that's gonna continue fucking with me. Oh my god. And I absolutely need this guy to move, because there's absolutely no other way to get to this guy. Yeah, see? He covers all the bases. So, yeah, and I tried to stand right about here, but he fucking moved. So it's like, what the hell am I supposed to do? I don't understand. So here we have a bit of a dilemma. The top left dragon won't move. I need him to move so that I can get by and approach the house from the north, because apparently that's the only safe way to get to it. Now, you might be wondering, why don't you visit the top right village? Because the top left village tells you that doing so will cause a change AI event, and presumably that makes the top left dragon move. Now, here's the thing. You are correct, but there's also multiple other things that will cause that dragon to move. I think one of them is if you cross one of the bridges. Another one, I think, is if you waste too many turns. So I didn't really consider visiting that top right village to be much of a viable option, especially since it creates a wall of Wallaces, as you saw. Now, with that said, that dragon still has really confusing AI, as does most of the dragons, because for some reason, depending on what you do, they just choose not to move. Like, I find out really late in this submission that standing on the mountains just makes them do nothing. I have no idea what the fuck was going on. So naturally, a lot of variables came into place that ended up ultimately confusing the living hell out of me and making this submission a lot more difficult than it needed to be. I'm just letting you know this in advance so that you don't write an angry comment questioning my ability to play video games. Like, it wouldn't be so bad if the submission had clearly defined rules, but it's not. The rules are not defined anymore. They're just kind of like, well, I'm gonna do whatever the fuck I want. And it wouldn't be so bad if it, like, oh, yeah. By the way, that can happen sometimes. Yeah, I'm gonna fucking save scum the shit out of this, because, like, if I have to guess that often on what the fuck I'm supposed to do, then I'm not gonna put up with that shit. Alright, let me guess. Yep. What do you know? And there's like a million dudes up here. Can't approach from down here. I'm gonna make a guess here and say that guy... Firstly, he's gonna kill me. Okay, now he's gonna fucking move. I think? Yes, he did move. Okay, so confirmed, he does in fact move, but you have to step over that bridge. Fucking guessing games, man. Oh my Jesus. You know what? I'm gonna post this image on Twitter. And then I'm gonna post. You guys are gonna see that on my Twitter before anything. Before this video comes up. Oh, that's like a perfect image to summarize Rage Fest. And I'm surrounded, so I'm done. Alright, well, at the very least, I understand one extra fucking rule that the game didn't tell me. Because I thought that standing over here was what triggered all the dragons. Because I'm pretty sure the cutscene says that. But that one dragon disobeys the fucking... Ugh. Yeah, I'm really mad, as you can guess. Alright, I think I mentioned this before, but I said that if you use an item on an area event, you'll trigger that area event and then be able to move again. So, knowing this, let's see what happens. I think I may have moved in the wrong range. Yes, I did. There we go. Okay, so now I triggered that shit. What? All right, what is your movement range? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All right, so I triggered all the enemies on the map. Oh, and it's raining now. So I can't do anything anyway. All right, while I'm giving this hack shit, I might as well praise it as well for certain things like Baldrick accommodated for even like micro situations such as this, right? So you want to get to that house, right? The game, he knows your first few moves are gonna be like to go to this spot right here so that you can reach over here without being in the range of these two dragons. He knows that you can move again after attacking, and maybe you'd want to go to this house. So guess what? Killing that exact wyvern causes that wyvern to spawn, blocking you from reaching that house. I think that's kind of genius. Now, if only the submission wasn't so fucking unintuitive. Like, honestly, I think my main problem is, like, I feel like maybe I missed something in one of the cutscenes. Like, maybe the one that said the change AI events will happen didn't maybe it said not all the dragons will do this, only some. And maybe I'm just missing that detail. Or maybe, like, there's a house, maybe that one specifically tells you that this guy moves if you activate him by crossing this bridge. I don't know, because I haven't been able to reach that house because I'm too busy dealing with all this other nonsense, and he like very specifically planned around me trying to get to that house. Like, it's both ingenious and fucked up. Oh, and well, there's another one. I have a feeling he put that there for a different scenario that isn't exactly the one I'm in right now. Okay, so I triggered the dragons. I am gonna fucking get into that house if it is the last thing. Fuck you! Oh my god, just fuck you. Straight up, fuck you. Oh. No. I'm not gonna end this clip until I reach that goddamn house. I should also mention that, because some people are probably going to call out the submission for not, like, indicating when the rain happens, the game does have eventing that specifically tells you when the rain is gonna happen. So, like, for the most part, this submission has very clearly established rules, but it's just that one dragon. For some reason, he decided, no, I'm not gonna make this one so clear. Which is why I'm trying to get to this house, just in case it specifically tells me that, and I'm just not, you know, then that would make up for that bullshit, because the game tells you very clearly. Well, now one of them is gonna step on that goddamn thing and ruin my day, and I'm gonna suddenly have a southern accent. Okay, there we go. They stepped on the roads, just as I predicted. I have an idea. A really fucking nuts idea. Oh, no. Oh my god, it's like the AI knows I want to be in that house! Ah! Just fuck, man! The simple act of visiting some fucking asshole is such an ordeal! I am gonna get the fuck in there. And you are gonna like it, game. You're gonna like it so hard, you'll never want to leave me alone. Oh my god. Like, on one hand, I'm like really fucking mad, but I'm also impressed by like all these little micro situations. I'm not sure, like, I don't know how to explain micro situations, but I guess the name, I guess the name speaks for itself. But yeah, now I'm gonna get boxed in again. Oh my god. Finally! Holy fucking shit! 12, 14 fucking turns for this shit! Oh my god, and I bet none of this shit is gonna be helpful. Oh, that's no money. Wind sword, which is not helpful really. That, well, that's super effective against the flyers. Assumably, not gonna jump to conclusions here. This one seems like the most useful. Might as well buy all this shit. Get rid of my fucking silver lance. And let's watch the impending fucking death. Yep. So, it seems to me that I'm supposed to visit that armory. I knew that house was gonna be crucial to my victory. In some way, shape, or form. Because that has to be something. They won't just put it there for no reason. But yeah, I don't know how I'm gonna make it work. Yeah, I might need to take a break, too. Because, like, this is really, really fucking getting on my nerves. There's, like, so many variables I have to somehow accommodate for. I don't know how the author expects anybody to be able to figure this out. Oh my god. Okay, I managed to enter the shop relatively early this time. And I got all this shit. So, let's find out which one increases my stats the most, if at all. Okay, none of them increase my stats. And it doesn't matter worth jack shit because these guys can attack you and you can't counterattack them. You have to explicitly attack them on player phase or else you're fucked. So I heard that, like, from one of the houses, it mentioned that you could penetrate the wall of Wallace's. So I'm gonna try something here. First, set my item to Mr. Gorbachev, which I'd like to add is a fantastic name. Okay, so let's trigger that. Alright, now I need to figure out what the fuck this does for me, strategically speaking. Well, for one, it traps me. Good to know. Alright, let's watch the animation just for the fuck of it. Bam! Oh, look at that damage. Alright, what does this do? Does this kill any of the enemies? Any of the millions of fucking enemies I'm dealing with? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that traps me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And I'm trapped here as well. Fucking great. Oh wait, hold on. He's hindered by the thing though. This spot I think is the only valid spot I can really use. What? Oh my god. Like, the bullshit never fucking stops. Alright, so. Now can I can one-hit KO these enemies with the wind sword. So that actually greatly lowers the amount of enemies I have to deal with in all. Yeah, and I can just wipe them out like that. Just, yeah, because the wyverns you can counterattack. Those aren't really a problem. It was the fact, though, it's worth noting that you couldn't actually really do anything about them either. Alright, so what does this do for me? Like, what is this whole wall? What purpose does it serve, if any? These guys don't do anything. They just fucking waste, they're just a waste of time. Though, And this guy is not consistent about when he moves. God, look at them fucking pile up. Holy shit. And I probably can't, like, outlast them either. I'm mainly focusing on killing the guys that can actually do harm to me. Because if I can at the very least lower their numbers, then the rest of these guys are not an issue. Of course, there could be some fucking arbitrary game over condition that I'm gonna get fucked over by. So there's that. Looking forward to that. Alright, so the rest of these guys can't do anything to me as far as I'm concerned. And it's raining again! What is- Oh my god. Oh my god. Just stop. Slowly whittling down the enemies. Glad I have to spend so much time doing all this shit against enemies that don't do anything besides hinder you, honestly. Okay, so now I'm gonna get boxed in by a million fucking dragons. I might have something. So, from the looks of it, they don't move if I'm on a tile that they can't do anything about. So if I just stand on mountains... Oh, hi there, fuckface. So if I just stand on tiles that they cannot traverse on, which seems to be mountains, maybe that was the whole key the whole time. Okay, so I can break through this guy. Okay, so now we're making some... Oh my god! He finally left the fucking spot! Oh my god! Oh, wait. Fucking ambush spawns, that's right. As if we didn't have enough fucking bullshit layered upon our bullshit. And let me guess, this one dragon that... allegedly doesn't attack me, out of all the three fucking dragons, is gonna attack me. No, he didn't. He did not attack me. 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 Let's fucking seize! Alright. Tech skips. What the fuck? Okay, I have questions. What was the point of that whole sane thing? Oh my god, thank god it's over. I thought this was gonna take another day. Oh my Jesus. Oh my Jesus, thank god it was short. It was unintuitive as fuck with the whole arbitrary fucking AI shit. You know what? Okay. I don't know that for sure. Maybe there was some instructions that I just, like, I didn't read over fully or something. Like, leave in the comments. Did I miss anything? Because, okay. Either way, it's done. Thank God it's short. What was up with, like, the same portion had no reason to be there. It was just kind of, oh, hey. Yeah. That exists. I don't know. Either way, I'm done. Sane in the membrane. Hold on. Alright, is this actually changed? Okay, it doesn't look like it. Why the fuck did you change this goddamn title? What the f- This submission is such a confusing thing. Blue units are allies. Okay, this is just tutorial shit. Oh, shit. What? But you're sane. And you're- What the f- Alright, I give up.
I need someone to review my FE hack. He needs to be someone who won't cut me slack. It's Marky Joe. He's arrived from his golden chalice.